Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Let's Play Guitar Hero 5, and in the last episode, we had a magnificent run. Never had a better, it's the definition of the last episode, and now we're gonna play Beastie Boys again, because that's the best song on this thing that's not copyrighted. I'm kidding. It is very copyrighted, but I have to kind of play it safe because Dancing With Myself, I have noticed, has blocked my... Dude, the whatever the last episode was we did, I think it was... Where did I upload it? I think it was 7 is uploaded. Dude, it was blocked in 244 countries! I've never seen that before, and that has got to be like a world record, right? I now hold the most... blocked, besides being completely blocked, just completely not allowed on YouTube, I have got to have the world record of most whatever, most countries blocked on a single YouTube video. 244, it's unreal. It's not even available in the Virgin Islands, which is the U.S. And I can't remember which song exactly, well it doesn't say, there's two songs on there that make it unviewable or blocked, at least in Denmark. But the Beastie Boys song is not one of them, so that's good. Luckily, their label is kind enough to let players to not block all their stuff. Anyway. Welcome back to Guitar Hero 5. It's been an interesting few days, partner. It's been working all the time. Been taking a few days off from recording. Been working on a Cameo. That's a game. That's an amazing game. I did miss you guys. Dude, what's everybody been up to? Been waiting on the next upload? Dude, I've had part 8 done for like a week, but it just takes so long to upload, man. So I had a guy, when I hung out with my friend last week or 2 weeks ago, I can't remember. He told me, man, you should be a streamer. Like, I think you got what it takes. And I was very flattered. You know, I took it very personally because I've always wanted to stream. I thought streaming was awesome. Like, the idea of it, like Twitch and everything it had going on. But, man, my internet just doesn't permit it. Or else I'd probably stream every day. I would definitely put all my achievement, like grinding, you know, and all that stuff for everyone to find, but, or not find, but to watch. And streaming is very much more responsive than YouTube. You know, you record something and you get almost immediate feedback, but with YouTube, I mean, it could take you days to upload a video. And I'm so used to being, like, in this mode. If there was a way where I could, like, start streaming and then view my own stream to see how the quality was, I would, Oh, man, but see, that's the thing. I don't know. It's all like... I know you can buffer it. I know with Twitch, they use, what is it, OBS or something like that? Whatever software that is. And you can, like, buffer it to where it'll... You can say you can buffer it to, like, a minute or something. And that way, like, everything you recorded, it will take a minute to process the video quality instead of just directly putting it out there. It'll, like... lag it behind a little bit to give your computer or whatever internet service provider enough time to, you know, upload it in a better quality. And I would do that, but I don't know how long, like, I'd have to play with it, and there's like a certain threshold of like how long I would want it to be, because it's not streaming if it's like an hour. Let's say you buffed it to an hour and then somebody's like leaving a comment like as they're seeing what they're, you know, and then you don't get that comment or that whatever recommendation until an hour after. So it's like, it kind of, after a point, it defeats the purpose. If I could get it within 45 seconds maybe, or maybe 2 minutes maximum, like I would really want to try to test it out. I don't even know what platform I would use. Oh, I know YouTube does their streaming thing, and that would probably be the most convenient thing for me. I didn't even think about what... It was a base challenge, and I wasn't even thinking. I'm sorry. So this doesn't even matter. Alright, what do we got here? What's the hardest song we got? I can't do Kryptonite, unfortunately, anymore. I can do Play That Funky Music, but I kind of want to do something short, so not Sultans of Swing. That one was blocked too, so let's see. Let's go with, I'll go with the Blur. It's kind of short. So maybe that's like the next logical step, like is to use YouTube streaming service, even though it's not very popular. You know, everybody's on like Twitch and, Mixer doesn't exist anymore, does it? Microsoft got rid of it, I think. I feel like if it's what am I trying to say here? Like making YouTube videos is just so much easier. And I feel like if I was meant to stream, at least at this time, it would have been made more available to me, and like the information, well, not information, but like, it would have presented itself to me in my life in some way. But you know, thinking back, me and John streamed once, but that was more of his streaming thing, not mine. I just kind of showed up. He had the internet, you know. He was living in Athens at the time. When I was young, it's not my problem. It's not my problem. I just don't really have the, because when you stream, like, you have to download, right? Like, from the viewer's perspective, you're essentially downloading that video, right? Well, no, you're streaming, but it's like you're just tapping into a feed, but there's, like, a download kind of aspect to it, because there's been times when my friend Josh was streaming through Mixer, and I wanted to watch him play Fallout or something. I don't know what he was doing, but the quality on my end was terrible, so there's like an element of downloading, and I don't think I have the best internet enough to where I could stream something and also like watch it on another device, and then I'd have to adjust it accordingly while watching that feed. So I don't know, just maybe I'm complicating it too much in my mind, but I just can't. Whammy as long as possible, lonely as the night. But I could play this song. This is one of the coolest songs ever to play. It's got like this open bluesy kind of, open kind of bluesy riff going on. And I always, well, not always, but when I picked up DJ Hero, I was so happy to see Billy Squire, that he had a version. Well, the thing about DJ Hero, it takes like rock songs and other different kinds of songs, and it blends them with rap music, but it's like musically it's fantastic, because they mix beats together, and it's I love DJ Hero, and then like that whole genre of mixing music is great. But they had Billy Squire's Big Beat on there. It appears a couple times in the story, but Lonely as the Night, God, such a fun song. Sorry. But that intro, I love that intro so much. Still kind of tricky. I'm not used to playing it sitting down, but you got to be articulate with that, especially when he does that hammer on or hammer offs from the fifth fret. Anyway, let's get back to reality here. Whoa, snap! Back to reality. Great little riff. Love this so much. I love that guitar sound too, man. It's like so fiery. Dun dun. And every time I hear this song, I think about that scene from Couples Retreat with Vince Vaughn. And the guy that worked at the resort when they're playing Guitar Hero. It's like they're playing the Guitar Hero 3 version of, or I think it's Guitar Hero 3. Guitar Hero 3 version, but it's got this song on it. Or maybe Guitar Hero 4. Somebody's watching you, baby. It's a little bit harder to spam those trills, and I've been playing a lot of Guitar Hero 3 recently. No, we got. I don't have to whammy anymore. Thank God. Da-na-na-na. I thought I'd play Race the Sun, because it'd been a while, and I've kind of gone through this, a few days ago I went through like this phase of trying to figure out my emotional problems, and I think a lot of it is I put a lot of undue stress on my heart and mind, and it's my own damn fault, but anyway, long story short, I played Race the Sun because I haven't played it in a while. And I checked the leaderboards just to see if I was still number 5, and someone had dethroned me by like 100,000 points. So I'm knocked down to number 6, man. Like, part of me wants to try to get the 5th place back, but like, I know how much work went into getting over 30 million in that game. I don't think I'm going to. But I'm probably never going to stop playing that game, so eventually I might be on a good run at some point. Another game I was thinking about getting into. I mean, I'm still kind of stuck down, or tied down, in the rare replay. I do want to finish that before. I'm almost done with Cameo. I'll have to come back and 100% that game individually, but I just want to get the rare replay out of my hair. So, like, the way the game does it, for anyone that's never played it, most of the stamps come from milestones in games, and the last five or six games, the milestones are just get 750 points in each game, achievement-wise. So, really, I'm more concerned with the rare replay completion than I am the completion of the 5 individual games, because it puts you in, like, Xbox 360 mode and all that stuff, and it's just, they're all separate individual games, but the rare replay, like, collectively, like, uses all your achievements to get stamps, so my concern is just finishing the replay and then going back at some point and really finishing each individual game. And Cameo, I don't think it's going to be that bad once I really... I don't really know the word. The whole A-ranking stuff is going to throw me for a little bit, I think. I tried it last night, but it's... I'm sorry, I can't talk and play at the same time. I tried it last night, but I didn't understand how the scoring system worked, so. But I'm gonna give it, I mean, I gotta do good or figure it out at some point. My fingers weren't in the right position there. That's what she said. Not to me, though. Sorry, I just missed this drum part there. Really weird. I kind of like it though. Good song. I like it. So yeah, I'm gonna start playing a lot of older games for days to come. I just been working so hard. The Rare Replay, I'm just getting burnt out. It's making me question my life. All my life choices. I'm like calling up ex-girlfriends asking what I did wrong, you know? Oh man! Dude, if there's ever a song that's gonna be blocked, it's probably gonna be this. Refill a star pyramid as many times as possible. God, this song is awesome. Like, I never really was into Nirvana, but I knew about this song. I knew about a few other Nirvana songs. But when I was really, like, I never really got to listen to this song. And I was so surprised they actually got Kurt Cobain's likeness. That blows my mind. I don't understand. That should be David Gruhl on the drums. Excuse me. This guitar, man, I don't know what's going on. Like, when I was playing Guitar Hero 3, it's like it'll hit random notes. Or it'll miss notes that I know I hit. But this, you know, the fact that this song was on this game, I was really able to analyze the tone, because I've never really had a chance or a reason to, like, look it up on YouTube with headphones on and really listen to it. Man, it's so beautiful. So aggressive, too. And then it just goes back to this, and it's like so peaceful and calm. My ex-girlfriend used to love Nirvana. Like that right there. I don't know what I did wrong. Maybe it's time to buy a new guitar. I wonder who did the motion capture for Kurt Cobain in this game, and if, like, he studied, like, all of his moves on stage or whatever. Like, how in-depth did he go to learning? Man, I don't know what the hell. I guess I didn't even think about it. Is it 1144? I think it is. It's like, no, it's something else. Is it? Oh, see, there's four main notes. This one, and this one. But there's like something in between that I don't really. It may just be open. I don't know. It's a good one, though. I don't have it on my iPod, so I never practice it. But, you know, it's easy to remember songs that are just like four notes that are the same position, just like moved one string down. And back in the day when we were learning how to play guitar, like that was, you know, one of those few that really, I don't know what you would call it, Stan. It's like you never forget the numbers and the hand placement on simple things like that. But
so ugly. That's okay, so are you. Broke up is Sunday morning. It's every day for all I care. I'm not scared. Light my candles in our days, cause I found God.
Had an older gentleman that I've since kind of become friends with. He used to work at the post office before he retired. I don't know his name, unfortunately, but he asked me once, or we were talking about the state of music nowadays. And, you know, I'm guilty of this. I'm not. My mic even working? I can't really hear myself in my. Okay. It better be working. We're talking about the state of music, and I've been guilty of this before in the past, definitely, especially when I was younger. How we only know like one or two songs by the band, and Nirvana was the one he brought up, and he said, like, how many kids today would know more Nirvana songs than Smells Like Teen Spirit? And he asked me how many I knew, and I named off, like, well, Smells Like Teen Spirit, Heart-Shaped Box, In Bloom, Lithium, and there's like two more that I knew of, but I can't remember them. And he said, see, like, you're like one of the only people that really go in depth with that stuff. And I'm thinking, man, knowing six songs, I don't know how many albums they released. I don't know how many songs they actually have, you know? I'm not the biggest Nirvana fan. You just happened to pick one that I knew a little bit about. But I knew what he was getting at. Unfortunately, artists today really only get one chance to show their stuff, you know, and it's in that single.
I'm so happy, cause today I found my friends in my head. I'm so ugly, that's okay, so are you. Broke our mirrors Sunday morning. It's every day for all I care. I'm not scared. Light my candles in our days, cause I found God.
Kind of had a funny moment a few days ago, kind of involving Kurt Cobain. Like, he wasn't there, but one of the guys that comes in and works for Coca-Cola and, you know, puts out all the Coke products, he was just leaving. Like, I was coming into the back room and he was walking out, and he had his daughter, like, holding her hand, like, walking her out, and he was leaving. And I said, oh my gosh, is this your daughter? And he said, yeah. And then, like, there was a little something said about music or something. I can't remember exactly the conversation. He was only there. It was like a 3-second thing. And I just pretty much said, hi, like, is this your daughter? And he said something else that kind of involved music or Nirvana. And I asked her, I said, do you know who Courtney Love is? And she said, no. And I said, good, you don't need to know. It was like a funny little thing. He laughed. He thought it was funny. Anyway, where are we up to? Oh my God! Thank you for watching, ladies and gentlemen. Here we'll keep doing you. We're going to finish this in the next episode. Absolute pleasure. Keep it real and peace.